On the medical watch, making robotic surgery kid-friendly.
Medical reporter Dina Bair has more on a new system for small patients.
Robotic surgery is not new. It's often used for gynecologic and uterine procedures to repair hernias or to remove the prostate. But there are limitations, especially when it comes to pediatric uses.
It is kind of pretty scary to think about it first.
Antonio Garcia had gallstones. He was experiencing pain and was at risk for infection.
So we recommend taking the gallbladder out on these kids because if you just take the stone out, another one's going to form.
It's a procedure commonly done using a less invasive approach, often a robot.
The problem with the current robotics is the instruments are quite large.
Standard attachments are 8 millimeters in diameter, about the size of a finger.
So this is a 3 millimeter instrument. You can see how small this is compared to my finger, for example.
The new smaller scale attachments are part of the Senhance system at Mount Sinai. Pediatric surgeon Dr. Tom E. Loeb used the device to treat Antonio.
At first, I was thinking of like all the possible ways the robot could like malfunction, since it's future technology, of course.
When we can use these smaller instruments in a patient, there's very little discomfort to the patient. You know, we're going right through the abdominal wall. There's barely even a wound to suture up at that point.
We saw the robot in action during an adult hernia procedure.
These are the same instruments that we use on the kids.
Surgeons insert 3 instruments and 1 camera telescope, which is slightly larger at 5 millimeters. Eye movements control the camera.
The Senhance has a safety feature that I really like for the kids. It only works if you have your foot on the pedal. And the whole thing ends up being less expensive because these 3 millimeter instruments are reusable.
Antonio underwent the robotic gallbladder removal in September.
This was our first pediatric patient done in the United States, actually.
3 more young patients, including an 8-year-old, benefited from the kid-sized tools.
Probably in a very short order, we're going to actually have the biggest pediatric experience in the world using this particular robotic system.
It's crazy to think about how I'm like, out of billions of people, I was one of the first, and the under 18, too.
Dr. Loeb says his goal is to use the instruments on smaller patients, even newborns, and for more sophisticated surgeries. The system requires a bit more setup time, but the procedure length is about the same. Back to you.